This is WKTV Journal In Focus. I'm Ken Norris. In focus today is Wyoming Public Schools Superintendent Tom Reeder. The district will be asking for voter support on November 7th for what will eventually be an investment of about $79.5 million into district infrastructure. The current approved millage would not increase or decrease, but the passage of the request would extend the current millage rate for 18 more years. Dr. Reeder is here to talk about the need for new district investment and to give us some details on the renewal request. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you so much.
So the bottom line with this request is that there is a need for massive renovation and modernization of Wyoming public school facilities. Give us some examples of what needs to be done and what would be done with this millage request.
Well, it was noted that we have about looking at 18 years of renovations that we want to be able to do. What I mean by that is we've got to be able to set our schools up for the next couple decades. It has been a couple decades since we passed our last millage. So approximately 1994, all of the HVAC systems, roofs, etc., were done, parking lots. They have not been done or had any major work since that time. Because of that, they're all past their life, or if you want to call it past their warranties. Mm-hmm. They're all starting to go bad. Those all need to be upgraded and redone. There's a significant cost in doing all those well beyond an operating millage. In addition, our buildings were built in a very different era. We have all of our buildings are approximately 52 or more years old. Many different things happened at that time. One, a lot of kids walk to school. Many of our kids take buses or their parents bring them. Our parking lots are not even adequate in size or in the flow of traffic in order to get kids in safely every single day, or at least not as good as we would like it to be. Science is different than it used to be. Technology was no such thing 50 years ago.
That's right.
So our buildings have been done little things here and there, but as they're getting older and older, as anything, whether it's your home or your car, at some point the number of things going wrong or breaking down becomes overwhelming, and we don't want to start over, but we need a huge overhaul of our buildings. This money will allow that to happen without an increase to our public.
And so it is not only taking current facilities and making them, giving them a longer lifespan, but there are some sort of structural changes, the changes to the high school to expand it a little so that the new grade can come in there.
It's not a little. It's a big difference. We had two high schools. Given in what happened in between 2008 and 2014, there's huge financial challenges in the state, and they continue to a bit. We resized our district, reconfigured things, and at that time we moved our high school over to the former Rogers High School, and our junior high was at the former Wyoming Park. In order to accommodate the number of kids, we had 10, 12, and 7, 8, 9. Our parents have requested, our staff has overwhelmingly said, we fully understand why you did that, but at some point, love to have the ninth grade back in the high school with the flow of the way the curriculum works for the state, et cetera, sports. So we said we would attempt to do that. The high school gets a total remodel. All the other buildings and sites get a significant remodel, but we're not adding on and moving everything around like we would at the high school.
That is the largest single the building that will see the largest single change, is that correct?
Correct.
High school building?
Out of the 79.5 million, approximately half, about 40 million of it, would be for the whole makeover of the high school building and grounds.
Okay. And as I have read, I mean, basically just about every building in the district is going to have something done to it, is that correct?
Every building will be remodeled, depending on what has been done over the years.
Yep.
Doors will get replaced, windows are getting replaced, lighting is getting updated, safety features put in, flooring, not just to do them, but if they haven't been updated so that they can go another 2 to 3 decades in order to get us where we want to go.
Very good. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about the current budget for Wyoming School District. Where does it get its money from, and how can I understand, certain money from the state can only be used in a certain way, money from this bond can only be used, from this millage can only be used in a certain way. Explain a little bit the budgeting of the district.
Most districts have what they call two pots of money. They'll say they'll have an operating budget, and then they have a bond budget or facilities type budget. Sometimes the operating budget can be used for facilities budget in order to repair things, but the bond budget, when you have a construction, is not used for operating. The operating fund is used for the everyday going on of a district. It pays salaries, it mows the lawn, it pays electrical bills, the gas bills, all of those kinds of things. But when you need to redo things, painting, sure, that's an operation one. You need to redo roofs. Our roofs are $7 million. I don't have that in an operation. I would need to take a huge loan out and pay that over a certain period of time to do those kinds of things. Then you go to the public and say, can we do a bond in order to make some of these things that need to happen that are, I would call, major redos of the district. We have not been successful. We have not been successful because most of the time when we've gone after it, it's been an increase in tax. Mm-hmm. This one is not an increase, it's an extension. So we believe this is very favorable for the general public. They've been very supportive of us. And so by using this other fund, the bond fund, it'll be solely used for, we always call it brick and mortar things.
Okay, and let me just make sure that I understand. So a lot of the operating funds, maybe the majority of it, comes through the state on a per student basis?
Correct.
Is that correct? And then the funds that we're talking about would come directly to the school district by its ability to sell bonds that would be paid for by
this
millage.
The majority of the funds are based on what they call student count, and they'll say each student is worth X number of dollars, which is approximately 7,500 right now.
Right.
So when you have all your student count, they give you the money, they do it over payments of each month, and then you operate your district. That comes from the state based on sales tax and other revenues that fall into the student fund. If you're gonna do something local, that's up to your own public to say we're going to support that or not. All buildings in Michigan were built on public tax dollars. Some pass them more often, so they do more renovations, updatings. Some are growing districts, so they need those funds in order to accommodate the number of students they have. So for our district, we have not had success in the recently, but with this, it's been about 20 some years since a major renovation, and some of our buildings still have many of the pieces inside and outside when they were originally 50 some plus years old.
Right. So so let's talk a little about specifically of this request that's going on. This district states, you know, clearly that there'll be no tax rate increase, but basically what this would do is that as current millage approvals come off of the books, this would allow you to continue at this same rate over a span of many years. I mean, is that a generalization?
No, that's fair, and that's what we're trying to do. Our public is really good with their funds, and they cannot afford to give us any more. We fully understand that. But what can you keep giving us what you're giving us?
Right.
So as the bonds expire, we have said, hey, can we keep bring new bonds in that will cover the additional needs over those years? So as they expire over the next 3 to 4 years, new bonds will take their place for that 18-year window.
Okay, is this a unique request as far as this, that it's gonna go over a period of time? And I mean, it is basically going to eventually replace three separate bond measures. Is this a unique thing, or has other districts done this?
Well, you'll usually see where districts will refinance, and we have too.
Okay.
We've refinanced twice, and both times saved the public taxpayers about $1.5 million.
Okay.
So they're all expiring at different times.
Right.
And if they were all expiring at the same time, kind of like if you had a car payment, mm-hmm. you don't usually take three loans out for your car. You have one payment and it expires. So we have three payments or three different bonds that happen. Those are all gonna expire. Now we would have one. It would all be joined into one. So when you talk about the 18-year window, when that happens in basically 2035-ish, mm-hmm. then they would all expire again at that time. And at that time, they probably will need some remodeling because they'll be at the end of another era of 20 years.
Right.
And so you'll have roofs and other things that'll need upkeep.
Okay. When I was doing some research on your district and on this measure, I ran across a couple of things that really interested me. Was that one was that the district has one of the lowest current millage rates in Kent County, and also that you have had a balanced budget for the last 5 years. Do those two things speak to the district being a good steward of public funds?
I believe we've made some very purposeful decisions that have allowed us to get there. We are number 14 out of 20, which means we have been trying to be prudent with the dollars you've given us with a bond request. Mm-hmm. The balancing the budget is the operation. When we were able to combine our two high schools, realign our buildings, we were able to release some funds and be able to keep funds alive in order to make other things possible, including balancing our budget each year. We try to stay ahead of that. I am very blessed with a very good chief financial officer who stays on top of those things. And we have made necessary cuts, whether it be administration, maintenance, or other things, in order to assure that we stay ahead of the curve and always between what our board has adopted, which is an 8 to 12% fund balance for that rainy day.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's go back once again, I guess, to the major work that's going to be done at the high school. That's going to be done in sort of two shifts or two.
Yes.
So give us a little bit of a feel for what the public will see if this is approved, and when would work start? When would the second phase start? Yep. Give me some idea of time frame.
Traditionally, when you pass a bond, you get all of the money up front, and you'll see in your school district or in an area all of the work done in about a 3-year window. Mm-hmm. Because we're scaling it over several years in terms of drawing from the public as they expire, this work is going to take over 8 years to get done. So it won't be done until about 2025. Basically two phases. The first phase is about 23, 24 million. That will start the high school and put the second story 30 classroom addition on. Mm-hmm. And then about 2 years after that, work will be completing there. We will generate the last of the 56 million, and then all the rest of the work will be done. We're hoping to start within about 18 months. It depends on how fast all the drawings and everything gets done. Mm-hmm. Related to moving forward with the high school project.
Very good. Okay, well, I want to thank you very much for coming into WKTV and for talking with us and talking with our audience and the voters about this millage. And we look forward to having you back whenever there's some news from Wyoming Public Schools.
All right, thank you. And thank you to the public for the wonderful support they've given to our schools.
This has been WKTV Journal In Focus. I'm Ken Norris. Thanks for joining us today. And remember, learn more, get involved.